So since the beginning of My Hero Academia, one of the points I've always stressed was how masterfully the characters are written. And if you know me, slash been around my channel for long enough, you know that my favorite genre in the moving image arts medium is character-driven dramas. From Game of Thrones to any of Wes Anderson's films to even anime like Toradora. So nevertheless, one of the constant topics I love to explore is the individual characters themselves. After all, I've dedicated whole videos to specific characters that I absolutely adore. So today, I kind of want to follow suit with this habit and talk about both Midoriya and Bakugo. You see, in both of their respective videos, I've briefly mentioned how the two characters play off of each other, but I've never had the chance to really explore their relationship in depth. So today, I want to talk about how the major themes that the two characters represent work together to lay the foundations for the narrative. So first and foremost, we have to establish that Midoriya and Bakugo are in fact foil characters. Should have paid more attention in some of those literature lectures, huh? Foil characters are two characters who have the same goals, but are fundamentally opposites. Now, a foil character can be the villain of the narrative, but in our case is merely the rival to our protagonist, Midoriya. Midoriya is sweet, kind-hearted almost to a fault, and an extreme optimist, whereas Bakugo is mean, foul-mouthed, and an extreme realist. Yet both characters share the same goal of becoming the next number one hero. And when we first meet both characters, their ideals are portrayed to be set in stone, but of course, we know better. So to better understand my point, let's go to the beginning of the narrative and see how both characters started, then watch as they learn from each other and evolve. In the first episode, we are introduced to both Bakugo and Midoriya. Midoriya is shown as a weak pushover, and Bakugo is just basically a bully. This is done to quickly establish their ideals. Bakugo sees the world through his power is everything mentality, whereas Midoriya believes that simply being nice and extremely considerate is the way. Needless to say, these two moralities clash at the beginning of the show, and we get to see both sides of the argument. Both of them have the defined goal of wanting to become the next number one hero, but as we will slowly learn, neither one of their ideals is strong enough to make them the next number one hero. Starting with Midoriya's mentality, it ends up being the primary reason All Might first takes interest in him, thus eventually leading Midoriya to inherit One For All, which is clearly advantageous. But this mentality gets the best of Midoriya in some occasions. For instance, Midoriya originally has trouble believing that he's worthy of such a gift, despite the enormous amount of work he's put forth towards it. A good example of this is when Midoriya sacrifices his chances of passing his entrance exams to get into UA in order to save somebody else. Granted, Midoriya still passes on a fluke, but he ends up barely making the cut. Bakugo's mentality is the opposite of Midoriya's, valuing strength and success over being nice and helpful. This is clearly beneficial in certain situations such as the UA entrance exams where Bakugo placed first. But as I stated, there are some clear downsides to Bakugo's mentality as well. For instance, Bakugo, despite being the top student at UA, is almost never treated as such, since no one really likes him. Even after winning the sports festival, he's treated almost like a rabid dog and is given less internship opportunities than Todoroki, i.e. the person he beat. Either way, we're getting a little ahead of ourselves here. So let's talk about the first major conflict between the two characters, Midoriya versus Bakugo in the Battle Trials arc. I feel like this arc is one of the most underappreciated arcs in all of My Hero Academia. The arc puts Ida and Bakugo versus Uraraka and Midoriya, where Midoriya's team is the heroes trying to disarm the bomb, and Bakugo's team is the villains trying to protect the bomb. This is where we first see the two characters clash with their moralities. Before this point, neither one of their perspectives had been properly challenged. Yet, here they are, representing their ideals in the form where they would be most effective. Bakugo's anger gets the best of him and he loses sight of the actual objective of the exercise in exchange for trying his hand at taking down Midoriya. While Midoriya maintains perfect focus on the exercise itself, but considers himself too weak to actually beat Bakugo in a fair fight. Thus, Midoriya makes a decision to win the exercise, but lose the fight. It's even brought up by the rest of the cast that even though Bakugo's team lost the exercise, from an outsider's perspective, it would appear as though the villains had won. This is the first major lesson that Bakugo and Midoriya learn from each other, because this is the first time their ideals are in direct conflict with each other, thus they display their weaknesses. Midoriya has a lot of self-doubt and seems to be willing to put himself at immense risk for situations that could be potentially solved through other means. And Bakugo is trying to overpower his opponents because he assumes that they are all significantly weaker than him. And thus, both characters begin to change. There is a reason that this confrontation happens in the last episode of this arc. This episode is quite literally named Bakugo's Start Line. This is the true beginning of the narrative, where Midoriya and Bakugo must learn to change the way they think so they really can become the next number one hero. This process is accelerated even further with the situations and challenges that both characters are put into. For instance, Midoriya losing the fight to Todoroki in the sports festival is an example where Midoriya's ideals are highlighted once again. Though saving Todoroki through his own words, Midoriya not only loses the sports festival, but also nearly destroys his arms. Bakugo's ideals are also highlighted again in the aptly named Rescue Bakugo arc. Once again, it's another situation where his raw power is truly meaningless and has to rely on others for help, forcing Bakugo to change how he perceives the idea of teamwork, since he understands that he is more so a detriment to the situation rather than being helpful. Leading me, finally, to the Provisional Hero License arc. This is the newest arc of the anime, and also the one that best shows how Midoriya and Bakugo have learned from each other. At the beginning of the exams, it seems as though nothing much has changed. Bakugo goes off on his own, and Midoriya stays with most of his classmates. But something strange happens to both of them. Bakugo is put in a situation where he must rely on someone else to pass the first stage of the exam. And not only does he technically face defeat because of this, he intentionally helps Kaminari by giving him some of his gear. I.e., understanding that his own strength is not enough to pass this particular exam. The same occurs for Midoriya. The show splits him off from most of the class, and he has to work together with only a few members he finds in order to pass the exam. And the one extremely notable scene is this one. Where one of the characters gets captured by Midoriya, he pleads to him, asking Midoriya not to eliminate him. But for the first time, we see Midoriya stand up for himself and say no. He also needs to pass the exam, thus he eliminates the other character. We even get to see Bakugo be nice to Midoriya in this episode. He openly states that it's no surprise that Midoriya passed the first stage of the exam, which is a major change in how Bakugo treats others. Which all seems like a positive change for both characters. This is until the second stage of the exam. Midoriya passes this stage of the exam, getting his license, but Bakugo doesn't. Bakugo fails this stage of the exam since he still struggles with being kind to other people, particularly in dire situations. So, in essence, his mindset hadn't changed enough for him to be able to pass. Bringing me to the most recent episode where Bakugo challenges Midoriya to another fight. You see, Bakugo is doing this not to test Midoriya, but to test himself. He has now accepted that his morality is flawed, thus he wants to test if it's completely flawed, which we know it's not. The truth lies somewhere in between Midoriya and Bakugo. Therefore, even though the two characters are about to fight, I doubt there will be a decisive winner. I think from this upcoming fight, the two of them will learn from each other and finally understand that they are going to have to work together in order to have a chance at becoming the next number one hero. Midoriya and Bakugo are amazing foil characters. Despite having the same goal, both characters' ideals are polar opposites. Yet through their interactions and ever-increasing exterior forces, both characters realize that their ideals are flawed. And without change, neither one of them will ever become the next number one hero. It's only due to the fact that both characters are so close to each other do they realize their flaws and truly aim to become the next number one hero. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like the video, maybe consider subscribing. I make anime-related content once a week on this channel. Oh god, okay, so I'm really hoping that Bakugo just doesn't, like, wipe the floor with Midoriya or vice versa, because if that happens, then, like, a third of this video is completely pointless, but I doubt it. I'm pretty certain it'll be like an unofficial tie. Either way, a huge shout out to all of my patrons. You guys are my heroes. If you're interested in seeing how I edit, chatting with me, or simply supporting the channel, I run a $1 a month Patreon to make that as easy as possible. Make sure you guys share, like, comment, and subscribe. This is Matt. Make sure you guys say manga, watch that goddamn anime!